Hi Padres, this is Chase, like the bank. I'm here with Liv, don't die. Char's in the car, and this is Dad Pod's Rent Rant. So, I've been told that, you know, if you're ever going to criticize something, you should do it in this, this style of like a crap sandwich, or a compliment sandwich, where you say something nice, and then you say something not so nice, and then you end it with something nice. So I'm gonna try that a little bit today. First, I would like to put out a compliment to Disney Plus for organizing the MCU.
I did it. My phone's doing it.
What are you doing?
Nothing.
We're in the middle of a rent rant. So first, I'd like to compliment Disney Plus for organizing the MCU categories in a way that is understandable for people like myself. So they put it like to where you can look at it in phase one, phase two, phase three order, or you can do it in chronological order. And then they have Marvel Legacy stuff, which I guess is things like the X-Men movies or Fantastic Four. They really set it up nicely to make up for all the time that it's just been really confusing. And this has been a major issue for me because I like to read comics quite a bit. I read them on the Marvel Comics app or on Comixology. And one of the issues there is that I never know what time frame the comic that I'm about to read is taking place. And so sometimes you'll see like an issue number one that has spoilers for something else that you haven't read. So like if you're not into like comics right now, like one of the big events that's happening is the Marvel Ten of Swords, which apparently there's 10 magical swords that are needed to defeat some enemy. I'm not really reading the Ten of Swords all that much, but this goes with the Dawn of X, House of X, which I guess is 10, really, to be honest with you. And I'm not really following this, but it's confusing because basically you can pick up any comic book and all this stuff that's in the past, you're just not going to be really familiar with. And what I'd really like to see is for them to start, you know, putting into consideration, you know, organizing this stuff in a way that new comic book readers can say, hey, I started reading after whatever event or post whatever event. And one of the reasons I say that is that I've taken my girls, Liv's no longer paying attention. She got bored after about 5 seconds. She does. I've taken my girls around. And, you know, sometimes people will see that they're wearing their Disney stuff or their Marvel stuff or whatever, or Charlotte carries around her Gwen Stacy, and, or she's wearing her Captain Marvel backpack or whatever. And someone will say something like, hey, you're a fan of Captain Marvel? Is that true? Why don't you tell me about the time that Carol Danvers fought with Rogue? And Charlotte has no idea what they're talking about because that's not where Captain Marvel is in the comic books. And it's not just that it's a spoiler thing, but it's really obnoxious that there's like this in-group of comic nerds that think that like if you don't know X, Y, and Z, all these little things, then you're not a real fan. So if you haven't read, you know, whatever, you're not a real fan. And I'd rather they just, you know, start organizing it more for us casual readers or casual nerds or casual comic fans that like our one Captain Marvel movie or our one Into the Spider-Verse, so that we can say, yeah, I started liking it at point X and I started following it after point X, and I don't know jack diddly about the Dawn of X, the Squad of X, the Ultimate X, the Super X, the Dumb X, the whatever the X that you think is the main thing. I don't know about it. I know about Captain Marvel. I know about Spider-Gwen. I know about whatever.
My name is Gwen Stacy.
I was bitten by a radioactive spider. And for the last 2 years, I've been the one and only Spider-Woman. You guys know the rest.
And don't question my authority on these subjects, because I'm just as awesome as you. All right? So I think that Marvel, Comixology, and all these other groups need to get with the picture and start doing what Disney Plus has done by making these categories more efficient, so that we can all, you know, follow along with these storylines at our own pace in the way that we are, without having to worry about whether we know everything that happened before it, and without having to worry about, like, oh, this is going to have spoilers for this or that or the other thing. For instance, I just read the first issue of She-Hulk. I gave it major compliments. I thought it was really, really good. But it really does shine a light on a whole bunch of past events of She-Hulk that you might just not know. And it would be nice to have like a chronological, like, hey, this is issue 1, but it takes place after all this other stuff. So that's my issue today. And since I have to end my episode with a compliment, I'm going to say, Charlotte, you're looking very nice today. You're very welcome. This is Chase, like the bank. There was a brief cameo with Liv. Don't die. This is Char in the car. And this is Dad Pod's Rent and Rant.
With no mommy.
Dad Pod's with no mommy.
No, there's no the wife. No.
That's how you call it.
Thanks for your assistance. And just one more thing, if you ever feel like it's okay to question a little kid's fandom by pop quizzing them, instead of just asking them, like, hey, what do you like about this? And then complimenting them on enjoying the same thing that you enjoy. If you ever feel like you have to give them a pop quiz, like every day is Avengers SAT that you're just waiting to slam onto some small, cute little 5-year-old or 8-year-old, you're an asshole.
And one more thing.
Oh, yeah?
Click like and subscribe and give us a 1,000 comments.